Thank you. agulo. Era louca e saiu da tijora. Ainda tem a da uja. E o boa da saia. E a uja. E a ia. E a minha mão. E a mão. E a gada. E o da mão. Home to Queen, Padota Campejuta. Niena Waka Ouna, Unkeye, Ferrer Wupila. Chantista.
In Lakesh.
Ayuta in Campuchi. We jagai. Ist man kann das schon da Franke Janagia Napita Kungau Kriya Ferrei Tawanagam Shanti Ista Unkit Awape Wanagi Unkia Naao Naahangiko Yeah, go Oko. Unaka Niena wa upe segura hai Lagi wa maho naka Mamaho 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 naka In the hands of Magazuna, Uyechane, Maekimu Chanze, Dagi Ushidja, Wazuya Nazukaya, Sabutanatao. Una wanta jamaka, wanta jamaka na wo, wo chande ize yo, yo beya tatara na peche yo.
What's making my stomach? It's the roux. The roux does your stomach. It's the roux feeling.
Yeah.
It makes it cramp up.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Yeah. Cinnamon roux is not my favorite.
That's why I put it in capsules, bro. It's fucking powerful as fuck, though.
It is.
It does the job.
I agree. It does.
See, I finally found some Aya for sale that ships here. So, but that, I got a nice supply of that roux. Definitely does the trick. It gets better too if you use it consistently. Like it's less cramp causing. But it's because I haven't used it in a couple weeks. Didn't you do that one last time? Or was it?
No, it was the other time.
try something else.
Thank you. Wow, dope. Bit of a hair.
Back on the medicine kick. Oh God. See, slowed down after that last Pant San Pedro experience, kind of ground out and stuff. And I was eating a whole bunch of vegan food, you know. Now the Syrian root is like, whoa, dude, you got a lot in your stomach.
Yeah. Usually you fast.
Mm-hmm. Good thing I only took one, man. Oh. See.
Literally wood cap.
Yeah. If you can develop over time, you can get to where you don't really need to eat much anymore. And I think if you do that, you get less inflammation in your body and stuff.
Inflammation builds up. It concentrates, like, in my back and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. I found a huge one right... See, the one on my left side that was really bad, that one's... Probably some still there, but it hasn't been hurting. It's one on my back. On
I heard knees right. Below the hips is where I do a little hip orientation. Yeah, the blood flow was way better. Oh my god.
Made this DMT extract that he was.
So this guy.
He'd been working on. And, He. I don't know all the steps, but, he got to the part where it was finally ready. It was like and he had it in some kind of liquid. I don't know what liquid you would have it in, but he put some on his finger and it, like, I just sniffed it and I started tripping. He did too. Like, just from the fumes.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's powerful.
Yeah. He ended up kind of zoned out on the couch and stuff, like having some kind of. He was seeing the whole room, I guess, with the third eye without having to look.
Interesting.
Yeah, she was doing this crazy dance. It was the most wild fucking dance. Her hands were going super ridiculously fast. She looked like some kind of ghost or something. Some kind of spirit.
That's awesome.
Oh. Say something about me, it might as well be that. If you guys didn't know, sometimes when you take certain things, you can see spirits and stuff. It's pretty fucking trippy, I would say. You probably knew, though, if you watch my show. It's one time this entire Soul family came and visited the house. They came back later, and they all had names, and they were all from, like, Arabia and shit. They had this monkey.
Right here?
Yeah. It was these invisible spirits. They were pretty fucking dope. One of them's name was Norex.
I love that.
Yeah. Whenever the world's fixed and we can make babies again, maybe I'll name my baby Norex.
Really?
Whenever the world's fixed.
Yeah, we have a good, solid foundation.
I think the whole place needs to be cleaned up, and then I would feel okay. I don't feel okay with all those crazy vampires on the loose.
You want to hear an interesting one? I had taken some medicine and I started using one of these rapes and it was really hitting the stomach really hard. I was using the eye and I think that's what did it. I started to feel really nauseous and stuff. I ended up barfing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the reason why I barfed is because I had a baked sweet potato. And it created a bunch of acidity. And I barfed up all this acid and felt better. But it taught me not to eat cooked food. Me and Zoe thought baked potatoes were, fine. But after that, I'm not gonna do it again. My mom was saying you can eat the potatoes raw. They're apparently edible if you just slice them. Never would have suspected.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Since I'm an anarchist and everything, I should be allowed to make whatever video I want.
True that.
And, trippy little fucking medicine videos. That sounds like a new genre, you know? You don't really see those very frequently.
Make it a thing.
Got sage and stuff too.
Yeah.
I agree.
Sage. Oh, it's in there, isn't it?
Set some intentions, maybe some healing, some love, some brotherhood and sisterhood, and maybe even some self-care.
In Lakesh.
To the four corners, the ascended masters,
Definitely all you truth tellers. May we all rest in peace. Oh, this is good shit. I love this stuff. Seven Bomer was saying it. I think it might have been Bro Yosef was saying it was a vibe lifter pretty much instantly.
I love that song too.
Every green leaf and every seed-bearing plant, they shall be yours for food. And to all the animals, all the beasts of the field, may thou eat every green leafy vegetable and fruit-bearing plant. They shall be yours for food. Stomach already feels better. Way better. Gonna get us some more Syrian roux. Maybe a harataka. Definitely another peyote. Yum. You'll be jamming all night, baby. For your entertainment. For your entertainment, we got a dried peyote on the tap. On the tap, on the down low. On the down low for show. I bet us some motherfucking a pine pollen, baby. For a squirt. Increase that squirt. What else we have? Ooh, that's funky. Ooh, I don't know. I don't know, baby. That's funky. Oh, what else we got in the bag? What else we got in the bag? I don't even know what this is. This is a haritake. Just what I needed. Just what I needed. One or two of those, please. More for me. More for me, sweetie. Got my co-shaman looking like a motherfucking Sasquatch over there. Keeping that beat loaded, throwing it down. Maybe a couple deems, baby. You guys like the deems? I think it's about to get wild. Going deep, sweeties. Getting litty. Litty blood splitty. Blood splitting. Lit off our ass. Till the morning, man, you know we throw down. We don't fuck with no nasty. Only the most pure, the most high class and high vibe. Got to be just right. Here we go, baby. Ooh, wee. We'll be right back. Yeah, I was saying it's getting close to the new moon and everything. And I kind of took a break after that last experience, which was on the full moon, right? And I was starting to sleep more, and I think we're getting close to the new moon, so it's good to set intentions and stuff.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Sure. And what I heard is that you can cycle it to where you're more, I think, giving things to the moon on the new moon, including intentions and stuff. And then the full moon brings you the fruit of your intention. That's what I heard. I think it's good advice. But it's really perfect timing because I recharged for like probably 2 weeks now. See, it's right about new moon. And I was just eating a bunch and resting and stuff, getting some sleep, you know? Mm-hmm. And yeah, I don't know, tonight I felt like dipping in a little bit, so it's good timing.
Yeah.
Right in time for the new moon to get those powerful intentions going. Bring some more money, some more property, some more clean water and food and air. For all my best friends.
I'm so glad I got with you.
Some more freedom. More freedom. So that we can do whatever we want. Forever. Mm-hmm. Hey, do you want to do me?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. My buddy's gonna do me.
Did you already put it in the small, deep bit?
Got some of the big ones here.
Oh. Or
all those intentions from the past coming true. All those thick and thick layers of intentions, like an onion. You peel them back and it's just more. More intention and more medicine. More attention and more medicine for all of us earthlings. Hang in.
Oh, I was gonna do me first. You.
Okay. Oh, you gotta do me? Okay. Fucking Baba G, bro.
Who's Baba G?
He's fucking a guru.
Oh.
He's an OG guru. Back when they were pure. He's supposedly like an ascended master now, and like he still visits Earth, but he can like fly and like has a whole crew. They can like do all kinds of magic, go to special places and stuff. That sounds like a good idea to me. I thought about printing off a picture of Baba G, put it on the wall. Maybe get a tapestry, a Baba G tapestry. It'd be even better. I put a mix in that one. What the hell was that?
turn into like a fucking cat or something. You ever shapeshift into animals and shit?
I was just flying around as the white hawk. Just
nice.
A little out of it. I was feeling my birdness.
Yeah. As a spider, one of the main dangers is birds. So you have to, they have like a sixth sense for what's in the air.
Well, hawks don't eat birds.
Do what?
Hawks don't eat birds.
Spiders.
Or spiders, maybe.
Yeah, spiders. Maybe the smaller ones do. Those fucking birds of prey with all the military missiles, fuck. Call it fucking Blackhawks. Blackhawks. That's what you gotta be careful for. Hydrating beverage.
Yeah.
I make some. I'm just gonna make some real quick.
It's good to think ahead. Like, you got me really good with that one.
Good, I'm glad.
Yeah, high five. One time, I had this thought at the peyote ceremony, where I was like, thinking that in a past life I was a slave master.
Oh, wow.
And I had to pay off karma and stuff. I didn't realize that, but, if it were true, I might have had to pay off karma. It was at one of the cave ceremonies, and I just felt like some reincarnated slave master from a past life, from like a plantation or something. Or it seemed different. It wasn't a plantation. It was like a European castle slave master or something. See, my mind automatically went to plantation, but I think it was more European. And then finally I remember at like the end of his life, he was like, yeah, slavery didn't really work, so I want to do something else. Or maybe that's what I was thinking at the ceremony as the reincarnated slave master.
Yeah.
I don't think it was a plantation, though. That's not... That wasn't the vibe. You ever shapeshift into, like, fictional characters?
What?
Well, I used to do it with the characters from the video game Mortal Kombat. Like,
when I was really young.
I mean, I used to do it, in the last few years. I learned a whole bunch of tricks from Raiden. He taught me all of his superpowers and shit. One of my favorite stories from that experience was, like, he taught me how to discharge a cop's taser. Say a cop were to try to tase you, and you're the god of electricity. Does it already sound like a bad idea?
No.
tase the god of electricity, as a crooked cop.
It's funny.
So what he taught me is you do a Kriya Yoga energy movement where you blow Kriya a straight, like, blue lightning beam out the top of your head of Kriya, and you keep that going higher and higher and higher until the cop's taser just discharges fully and the battery drains. And then what you do, and maybe if you're really good at it and really clear, you could quickly drain the battery, but whenever the battery drains, you allow the Kriya to then shoot back down from like 1,000 feet in the air back into your body, and then you channel it through your fingers, and then you shoot a lightning bolt and blow him up or something, or you stun him, something like that. Blow him up is kind of what I was thinking though. That was one of Raiden's fatalities. Just electrocute a person till they explode.
Yeah. Fake that. Wow.
What's up, guys? There's a lot of really, really terrible warning signs of just Armageddon. I think the global elites have really stirred up quite a bit of shit. And, you know, whenever people figure out what happened, I feel like they're gonna be really fucking angry about it. And could just get pretty ugly. So always be prepared and be sure to have a solid exit plan from the Matrix and cities and stuff, because you never know what might happen, and it would just be terrible to get caught in the wrong place at the wrong time. You know, it'd be like some American Civil War II, this time with nukes, you know. I don't like the sound of that myself, so let's just hope that doesn't happen. That's what I have to say. Let's just hope everyone chills out, cools off, maybe thinks about what they've been allowing for so long. Life can really be a party. It sure can. It can be a fun, happy adventure with plenty of magic for everybody. All we have to do is choose it. That's all we have to do. Is choose the right path. The path of truth and knowledge and hope and love. And freedom. The path of everlasting youth. Down the hatch. Here we go, baby. Thank you. as the moonlight shines, the slush on the leaves under the dark, the cover of night. The darkness, shining light on the prowlers in the wilderness. The shaman waits for the path to be shown, the way to be made safe for everyone. The shaman awaits in the darkness, faces all the shadows. The creatures that go bump in the night. The shaman rescues, just take his hands. Program the destiny. Just use your third eye a little bit. See the pathway to the future. Pathway to safety. Peace and success. Freedom and truth. Love and joy. Peace and harmony between the tribes. Free.
to be wild and free. Just leave them all alone. Mother Earth will heal and restore peace in the final days. Said Mother will heal herself in the final days. The final days of humanity. The parasites are gone. The oil is released. Back to Mother Earth. Mother Gaia will heal herself long after humans leave. Just leave her alone. She will heal your soul. Spiritual uplift coming from the earth. Mind the water and the fire, the air. Safety and fun. here for your life, safety, and fun. Friends. Family. Thank you. space and the planet. Heal of the earth. Heal friends. The bears and the girls. Yeah. paradise. Onward. To paradise, baby. Calming joy for the pain.